Greetings. It is such a joy to bring you devotion sponsored by the Diocese of the Bahamas and the Turks and Caicos Islands. I am Father Dave Thomas, the priest in charge of Holy Savior Parish, Cat Island. Let us pray. Let your continual mercy, O Lord, cleanse and defend your church. And because it cannot continue in safety without your help, protect and govern it always by your goodness. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew, the 14th chapter, beginning at the 22nd. Verse. Immediately he made the disciples get into a boat and go on ahead to the other side, while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But by this time the boat, battered by the waves, was far from the land, for the wind was against them. And early in the morning he came walking toward them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat, started walking on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." When they had crossed over, they came to the land of Gennesaret. After the people of that place recognized him, they sent word to the whole surrounding region, and people brought all who were sick to him and begged him that they might touch even the fringe of his cloak, and all who touched it were healed. This is the gospel of Christ. The image of Peter walking on the water caught my attention. As Peter stepped out of the boat, he had to choose between two focal points. On the one hand, there was the sea of chaos, and according to the Gospel of John, this is the Sea of Capernaum. Then on the other side, there is the steady and calm figure of our Lord, standing upright amidst all the chaos with his hands outstretched. As long as Peter focused on Jesus, who bid him to come to him, he walked over the sea. However, when he started to focus on the sea of chaos, he began to sink. Now let us place ourselves in place of Peter, that we too have to choose between two contrary choices almost each and every day of our lives. There is the sea of chaos, pressing within and outside of us, crashing against us, and making every new step in life so difficult and confusing sometimes. That feeling that Mama used to describe as between, oh Lord, and thank God, or the description of between a rock and a hard place. There is an internal sea of chaos within each of us. And most times when life gets difficult, sometimes the natural inclination is to turn to evil. When we lose loved ones, sometimes we want revenge. When people do evil to us, we want to get them back. When church people say the wrong things to us, we want to answer them. There are times when we try to fight and fail most often. Then there are emotional struggles, ego, fear, insecurity, and many more. There is also a sea of chaos around us. Issues in our families, issues in our relationships, issues on our workplace, issues in our church life, and so on. However, amidst all that is going on in us and around us, the gospel reassures us that our Lord is standing upright, steady, and calm, with his arms outstretched, waiting for us. Very often, like Peter, we get tired of crying, tired of trying, tired of struggling, tired of being the better person, tired of being the Christian when people take advantage and walk over us. Like Peter, we get battered by the sea of chaos and we sink as a result. And we sink not because the weight or load is too heavy. We sink because the focal point is wrong. We give attention to the weight of the load and not the distance of the journey, or even the assistance that God offers us for the journey. We give attention to the chaos in us and around us and try to deal with it using our own abilities. But Jesus says to us, wait, stop, take heart and come. Whatever chaos that continues to beat you, be assured that the Lord is there with his arms outstretched. Let us pray. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, Almighty and Everlasting God, who has safely brought us to the beginning of this new day, defend us in the same with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that all our doings and all our choices may be ordered by thy governance, to do always that which is righteous in thy sight. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please share this devotion with those around, and we thank you for listening once again. God bless you.